Do! Flippin' Flippy track.
That's
what I was basing that one on.
That's why you said it. It's not a GTA playlist.
Rossism.
Bag a roach,
I guess.
I picked the roach.
This is called Xenoarchaeology. Nihilate.
So it's that. Xeno, meaning, you know.
Yep, go on.
Go on,
educate us.
Really educate us. You're kicking off.
You're a teacher of our time.
Just a sentience, right?
Sentience, right.
Of alien past. And right.
Okay.
I saw an article in the news today. Well, it was less news and more sort of like one of those websites you see people posting shit on Facebook.
We recorded this today.
It's not going to be hugely relevant, actually, time-wise.
Is it not? Okay.
No, it was about a mother of two who claims over £5 million in benefits every year.
Right.
What?
Right.
How?
Yeah. So she's got two kids.
That seems like a lot.
And the government gives her £5 million
How?
A year, they reckon.
What happens?
Wow.
She's one of the, you know, she's a Duchess of Cambridge, mate. She's Kate Middleton.
It's Kate Middleton.
There, that was the article. So I was like, what the fuck? 5 million. And I looked in and it was, yeah. But to be fair,
it's an interesting point. Where's that money come from?
Well, this is the thing, right?
Taxpayers.
They didn't go into detail. And I reckon that in part, there is some justification for it, which I'll go over. But basically, they claim the equivalent of £96,000 a month, I think it was, or a week.
Right.
In for some form of royal expenses. Yeah,
it's cheap living, isn't it?
Yeah. For the two of them.
Royal expenses.
Well, for their family. Yeah, because the royal family is obviously funded, you know, in part, I guess, by the taxpayer. This is the thing. Like, I don't know. Do you guys know? Like,
this is already an
example of why we're in this situation, let's be honest.
No, I don't.
None of us really know who the fuck's paying for it.
I'm actually a bit infuriated.
Hey, Siri.
Why is this the thing?
Hey, Siri.
I thought they owned loads of
land,
right?
Does the taxpayer pay for the monarchy?
Well, what does it do?
Huh?
What do they do?
They do royal appearances. They do openings and closings. They create the entire.
Yeah, but so does Jeremy Clarkson.
Yes.
So I mean, like, a bit
guys,
is paid by the event.
We pay 56p each for upkeep of the monarchy.
Right.
Whoa. I see.
Yeah,
so I can
a,
see
a
why
lot,
people.
A month.
I didn't really understand fully before, like, when there's been like protests about like the royal family and, you know, shutting down the monarchy and etc. I didn't really understand the costs of it all. I mean, obviously, you know, per person it's not a crazy amount, but it does seem odd that that's something we need to upkeep. I mean,
well, the thing is, right, the way
is it for
the,
tourism
the way
yeah
that's what basically what I'm thinking.
We bring in tourism and
because
the whole economy.
Potentially, I mean, if it
I reckon
that much value, that could be worth
exactly
it.
I think probably somebody's done the maths and gone to be fair, if we keep funding the royals,
queen, yeah,
our country's going to make more money from
more
having
through
that.
People being like obsessed with
exactly
like that
which
weddings,
we're very good at. People
which
love the English
fine
monarchy, don't they?
Yeah,
especially
yeah,
the Americans.
Fuck you,
we got you.
Have to serve purpose. It's just when you see it in those numbers, you're like, whoa, oh shit, that's crazy. But then I guess, you know.
But this is the thing, and they showed a photo of her, and they're like, mother of two wears diamond crown whilst riding around in the back of a Bentley.
Making her sound like such a pompous prick. When she came from a relatively, you know, obviously middle class background, but like, still, like, yeah.
Ultimately, you
wearing
know
a tiara, riding a horse.
Well, she had a diamond crown on. No, but she did. She literally had a photo of her with a diamond crown
okay
in the back of a Rolls or a Bentley. And it is kind of like,
oh, that's clever.
Ooh, like, I mean, I get it. I do get the need for the tourist element and all that sort of stuff. It's just, you would have thought at some point a royal would have gone, oh, maybe we don't, you know, need to do the diamond crown
turn
thing.
Turn it down.
But I think you do, though. I think that's it.
Yeah,
you
they need that
up
level of
yeah
ridiculous.
Yeah. Well, that's
need
the thing. Yeah.
Pomposity.
Like we were literally saying about tourism. Like, that's the thing that people like
but
looking
for,
isn't it?
But I think if a clever enough spin on something, if you really PR'd the shit out of it and made them seem like a real people's person, you know, like a real, like, oh, she had this diamond crown, but she sold it for, you know, to build a school or something like that. Like, imagine how good that would make a person look.
Oh, definitely. Yeah.
And you're right, it still needs to be an element of pomp and ceremony, but do they need, you know, a diamond crown?
Yeah, like, she wears a diamond crown, then tosses it into the crowd and says, fuck that shit.
KFC for everyone.
I think
KFC's all around.
That's probably good for the nation, as in the locals.
Yeah.
But I don't think that would necessarily bring tourism.
It would. No, if you made sure it was well
there
promoted to improve the legend of that queen or princess. You know?
Yeah, yeah, true.
If it's it was plastered all over the place, like, oh
then,
my God, can you believe she gave away
but
a diamond
no
crown?
No one really sees them. You don't come over to Oh, get a tour to see the Queen.
Some people do.
And yeah. see how amazing her personality is. You just you want to see the crown.
The building, yeah, you don't
but see ultimately, Diana was famed for her kind of humble nature.
Yeah, exactly.
That's true.
Finish first, GFY, I'm not saying go fuck a dick. Sorry. Anyway, Diana was humble. And that was kind of her trait. You know, she went out and did all the charity work that a lot of them do anyway.
Yeah.
But yeah.
And this is why I think taxpayers... where some of the justification for taxpayers paying for them goes is hopefully when they do these royal appearances and charity stuff and all that sort of stuff,
they represent us.
That money is used for that sort of stuff.
Okay, but I mean, they're not going to be. Do you think they'll be worse off if the taxpayers aren't chipping into that?
Well, like you say, I'm sure they've got a massive portfolio of property and God knows what else.
Well, yeah.
Same time though, it's kind of we are giving to what essentially is our biggest representation of our country.
Well, yeah, I mean,
and
if
therefore, if I'm paying 56p a month or a year, I'd rather have our monarchy looking the best it possibly can for other countries.
Yeah,
right?
Of course,
but it can look good in different ways, can't it?
It can. I'm not saying the biggest, boldest diamond crown that you can come across, but yeah,
still in a way that
represent
good.
Us in a positive light. Yeah, that's also unique.
I really used to detest the idea of the monarchy when I was younger, but I kind of don't so much anymore. Maybe that's...
because you want to be king?
I just can't wait to be king.
And effectively, it kind of works in the same way as, like, I don't know, just British celebrities. Like, Hugh Laurie was awarded with a star on the Hollywood...
Yeah, but I'm
it
not
cost
paying.
$300,000. You know?
Really?
$300,000.
You have to pay for it.
You have to pay the people who do it.
What?
$300,000 for that star.
If you
star.
Want one, yeah.
That's he's why Clint paid Eastwood doesn't have grand.
One. Yeah.
That seems ludicrous.
Exactly.
Donate it to charity and just accept that, you know, that's that. You know, you hit that stage.
He wants to go down in the floor of Hollywood Boulevard.
I would just be like, no, I was offered it, but I put that money to good use.
Yeah, exactly.
Holy shit, $300,000.
Yeah, but that's fine for a story, you know, that people read. It's like, oh, that's nice of him. But every time you walk around Hollywood, you know, you see his name.
Yeah, but you'll be next to the likes of Donald Trump and, like, you know what I mean? It's just like, who cares? Yeah. Who really cares? You're walking on
You'd be surprised
slabs.
Who cares, though.
Your body of work is probably more valuable.
Hugh Laurie's amazing. Like, he's, like, the stuff he's done is...
Exactly. It speaks for itself, though, doesn't it?
Do
you know what I mean? Some of these accolades and awards... You win awards at award shows and stuff. That's probably more valuable than, you know, a slab in the ground. Probably one of the tackiest areas of LA.
Yeah, right.
So it's just like, you know... I wouldn't. I mean, Christ, you wouldn't pay $300,000.
Yeah.
If it was a bit cheaper, you might be like, "Well, okay, that's reasonable." But $300,000.
Maybe somebody else said they'd do it. Maybe like the house, like people.
That's true.
Could have even been like
true.
Contract
yeah.
negotiations.
That's
like,
very true. It could have been a production
it,
company,
yeah.
but
yeah.
It sounds pretty steep either way. Like, whoa.
Yeah, but in the grand scheme,
if they're paying for it, then you'd probably be like, "Oh, well, yeah." Fine.
It's going to raise the profile of that guy. That's then going to be in their next production. So. If they're that
do you think? Do you think they're looking at the slabs on the ground and going, "Oh, wow"?
Because there's a big old ceremony.
Or they're looking
about
at house and going, "He's really good at that."
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Yeah. Like, I know there's a big old ceremony, but like they get forgotten pretty quickly. Like, can you name five people on the?
I can only guess at it. Like, I could just guess.
Johnny Depp.
Like Michael Jackson's probably on it, right?
Michael Jackson, yeah.
Like, yeah, Leo.
Donald Trump
Leo
is actually
DiCaprio.
On there, I believe, because I think I saw some article
Arnold
where they were like spitting on.
Dwayne Johnson was in the Chinese theater, I think.
Was it really?
Yeah, the cement thing.
Yeah, yeah.
But
is that different? Is the handprint different from the star?
Yeah.
Okay.
It is.
They're wait, what?
Two
there are
things.
Two different things?
Yeah. You know, the Chinese theatre.
Man's Chinese
theatre. I know the
theatre.
Basically,
the concrete slabs on the floor.
Yeah.
You basically take one of those and put your feet and your hands in them. Which is weird because most people do it with their shoes on and it's just the shoe.
Yeah, it's just a shoe print. Well, what shoes am I going to wear today?
Oh, shit. Those
you're barefoot.
The,
what,
I brought the
what
wrong
does
shoes.
That show? What is that showing other than, you got some
they
really
walked,
nice shoes.
They walked here amongst you, these gods of the theatre.
You
the
can
movie.
Just walk past there and that's it. You've done that same experience. You know,
this is the thing. This is the whole thing about meeting celebrities in general. It's kind of like...
Go to the Eiffel Tower.
On this
you've already walked where fucking thousands and thousands of celebrities and other people have been.
I'll tell
and
you what, though.
Throwing themselves off of as well.
Yeah, potentially.
It's just about... you got to ground them.
Do you think this happens a lot?
You got to ground
Tower?
Them.
Well, the Eiffel Tower, yeah. Do you think they're throwing... there's a lot of people throwing themselves off?
There was
off
something like the first guy who thought of... it was something like there was a French inventor who thought of a paraglider or something like that, and to test it, he jumped off of the Eiffel Tower. And this is one of those spurious facts.
I think I've heard that.
Yeah, but it wasn't the fall that killed him; it was the heart attack he had on the way down before he hit the ground.
Shit.
Yeah, nuts, eh?
That's or reaching crazy. Terminal velocity.
Well, no, he was just shit scared. He's about to hit the ground, and apparently had a heart attack. And so, yeah, you know, I mean,
either way,
pioneers, though, eh? Pioneers of flight. Wow, you've got to be pretty
fucking risky,
pretty crazy to be a pioneer of flying.
Like, okay, we've potentially invented quantum technology, but we gotta have someone go through it first.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It's like the whole teleport
thing.
Will
all my particles be ripped apart?
Well,
yeah,
imagine the first person to have their consciousness transferred into a computer.
It's like, yeah, then it's the whole debate of, is that really
is that
the
their
same
conscious
person?
Or is it just a pattern of consciousness?
Is it just a storage?
Yeah.
It really, it's not really moving or like growing in any way.
And from their perspective, will they just suddenly appear in that new body, or will it be a whole new person that's born again?
Yeah. I'm guessing neither of you have watched the Black Mirrors yet.
I've watched the first one, the one about the likes.
Oh right, okay, yeah. That one's okay. I don't think that's the strongest one so far. I've only seen three.
It's Black Mirror about all the worries and fears about the zeitgeist.
It's not necessarily about the worries. It's kind of like an exaggerated version of
if it went
kind of the future potentially in some cases. So some cases the future, some cases
if shit got the way it wanted.
Well, if things got out of hand. So the first one is about like kind of social normality being changed into this rating system, which I believe is in Community, where
yeah, it was, yeah,
where you're rating people on how they are to you, and
sounds a bit,
and then obviously employers are judging you based on your likability. So it becomes like a social class thing. So like, you know, the ones who are up the 5-star rating are kind of, you know, considered, you know, better. So
you get like,
you know,
privileges, like cheaper flights. And stuff.
Yeah, exactly.
It is a bit cheesy, Trot.
It is really fucking cheesy. That episode is probably the cheesiest of them
all.
It's
interesting to see it examined. After it gets a bit better as the episode goes on. The first half, I'm like, oh fuck, this is so stupid.
Yeah. But yeah, definitely. It was so it was so exaggerated that it didn't seem normal.
No.
Do you know what I mean? Where is it supposed to be? It's written by Charlie Brooker and other people as well now.
Yeah.
But it's combined with Netflix and a lot more of.
Is it an American production?
It is now.
It seems
yeah. It is now. You can tell because it's really fucking good. It looks really good.
Yeah. Unlike most British.
Well, no. If you watch series 1 and 2, like, it looks really good, but it definitely didn't have the budget that it has now.
Have you seen that Channel 4 thing? That's
watching
coming
that
out?
Bad boy in 4K looks good. Sorry.
Channel 4 thing coming out soon, where called Humans.
Yeah.
Humans. Season yeah. Yes. Two, maybe. Season 2, I think, because
they've all got green eyes. And
season 1
really
was really good.
Was it?
Yeah.
You liked it?
Yeah, it's really good. I thought. Yeah.
It sounds similar to the whole Westworld thing.
To a degree, but basically it's set in our time now, and they cost, you know, they're like an expensive car.
Logan.
And the intention is that they just help you, well, in the story that we're following, that they help you with day-to-day tasks. But then there becomes, you know, elements
classic.
Of sexuality, elements of kind of the seediness of it as well. Kind of very AI-like. You've seen AI?
Yeah.
With
Haley right.
Joel Osment before he got big.
And Robin Williams.
Sorry?
Robin Williams is an AI, right?
I think he was,
as
the
Bicentennial Man, isn't it?
No, he was Bicentennial Man. He was also
I
in
mix
this,
those
but as
two
it,
up all
no,
the time.
He's in it too. I think his voice is in it as a.
I am thinking of
as a scientist
Man.
Actor thing that he has to go and see. But it raises those questions of you have sex bots, you have like kind of so basically there are these robots which are like basically used and abused, and it's kind of like then they kind of
but do they beat the Turing
then it's
test?
The whole sentience thing. So do they gain sentience and kind of like realize what they are or who they are and like oh shit like
what is sentience?
And they realize they have the power to live their own life and or do what they want.
That's something I found interesting about Westworld is the way I can't remember his name, the scientist that's like doing experimental and doing the interviews with Dolores.
Oh,
I don't want to spoil anything for anyone who hasn't watched it, but the way he words things is like she starts doing abstract like sentences.
Yeah.
And then he says things like, is that something we gave you? Or is it, which kind of like, it gives me that impression of like, that could still be a very human thing. You know, even though they're injected with code or a script, that's no different from, you know, a cult-based mind control, constant, like, drill a sentence into that person.
You see it a couple times in the show. I mean, I don't want to spoil anything, but, like, you see it a couple times in the show when, like, people actually tell them or, like, say, oh, you're just a robot or something like that.
Yeah.
Or they say something similar to that, and it's just like, well,
they must have a fail-safe.
They don't process that. Like, they're told not to process that.
They've
so it's just like,
coded.
Shit. But, I mean, I imagine at times you'd be like, oh, don't worry, you'll be fine.
Yeah,
or you would just forget about it.
But
the thing I don't like about it is the fact that the game is pointless if you can't get hurt or kind of get kicked out or something.
You can get hurt by the environment still. Like
but
if
like,
someone hits
I think
a rock,
ultimately
that can hurt you.
Ultimately, regardless of whether it hurts you or not, your experience should be kind of like respawn. So you don't just stand there and take a fucking, you know, 20 bullets.
You right, should you lose just
like
progress,
go back and then you're like, oh, I
and
screwed
they forget
up.
About
and
you.
Therefore, there's a reason for you to actually do well and or like succeed. Unless there's different packages, it doesn't really explain all the details. It just says it costs like 40 grand a day, was it? Or 40 grand a session or something?
Something tells me that they're developing that as a storyline, though.
Yeah.
As in, like, people are so used to being able to stand in gunfire.
Yeah.
That suddenly, when somebody gets taken down, they're like, "Holy fuck, they can hurt us now!" Like, that's going to be
because even the hosts look surprised when that happens. Yeah. Like, oh god. Oh shit. This is just pointless. And just
but do you remember when that guy, the other guy? Again, this is we're trying to keep a spoiler.
If anyone's Westworld is, we didn't really explain what it is. It's a new series on HBO. If you haven't seen it, it's
Sky Atlantic.
Based on a 1970s film, is it? Or is it a TV show as well? I can't remember.
It's Michael Crichton that wrote it.
It's very interesting, yeah.
It's
the whole Jurassic Park element. So clearly Michael Crichton loves parks.
fucking loves them.
And yeah, it's really interesting. It's filled with debauchery and kind of, you know, there's rapey elements and violent elements, but...
It's the Wild West.
That's why people are comparing it to Game of Thrones, I think, when they're saying that. They're
it's
violent. Yeah, there's a lot of people going, oh, it's the next Game of Thrones, which I imagine they're loving because it's like a great marketing ploy. Mm-hmm.
When you see that noisy HBO ident, do you instantly think that it's going to go dun, 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 straight after it, does
that? No, because I've seen a lot of HBO stuff. Like, what's the one with Larry David in? That always starts with that.
Curb Your Enthusiasm?
Yeah, Curb Your Enthusiasm.
Well, for me, what I really liked
and
is Generation
Sopranos.
Kill. Generation Kill started with it, and what was really good is it went to Radio Static normally afterwards as well, so it kind of transitioned.
A lot of fucking noise.
Yeah, I fucking love that show. I say it all the time. But yeah. Generation Kill was amazing.
Yeah. Yeah, Westworld,
also,
check
it out.
Also,
if you hate really gory like things Westworld. And you're also really into The Walking Dead, don't watch the first episode. That's what I'm going to say. Let's not say more.
Fucking hell.
I haven't seen it.
It's horrible.
Yeah.
And I've seen gory stuff. You guys know that.
Yeah. Ross likes
real
to scar
gore.
Real
himself.
Gore, like horrible, like shit that Reddit just fucking produces sometimes.
Well,
like,
yeah. Reddit produces you.
I find it accidentally.
Accidentally is not true.
I don't
it's
search
amazing.
For it specifically.
It's amazing how many times you've accidentally come across just terrifying shit.
Whenever we do a shared. Okay, so we do shared videos in terms of when we do a single player video. We all look at one screen. It's always trots. He always brings up like weird stuff. Like you'll type in dog porn and don't type it in. He's like,
I like the shock factor of what you guys see.
True.
You're doing that on your own, Ross. Finding these links and like, I'll watch
that. I come across them. Are all they're there somewhere? They're floating around.
I go on are all the time.
Yeah.
And I skip past.
You gotta go deep, motherfucker.
Deeper.
You do have to go deep.
Have you got deep?
Like,
web?
Oh. Deep web? No, it's just literally on.
Oh, I'm deep web.
Chrome.
I'm deep web.
Oh, he's deep web.
I'm touring.
He's touring.
When I look on TripAdvisor for my next cafe to eat at, I use Tor. Fuck.
What cafe?
I don't want that risk. You know, you've got to use some sort of secure browser.
You don't know who's watching, mate.
Exactly. They could come to that cafe and be like, "Hey, it's that internet troll, Al Smithy."
I spray hairspray all over my face as well.
What,
you know, like it does the number
shine.
Plates. Yeah.
Yeah.
Just a blur. I can't see very well.
Fuck, that's amazing though.
No one's going to get me.
You should probably keep that to a secret.
Also, though. I like shake my head violently as well.
Whenever you see a camera. Yeah.
There's another really interesting Black Mirror episode, which is, about like...
privacy?
Being hacked and stuff. Yeah. It's pretty brutal. And like just being blackmailed by people who just, you know...
Is there an episode where...
stupid stuff on their webcam?
People are part tech and they've got... implementations in their brain where you can a neural network.
Isn't that already one from the previous series?
I don't know. The one which I really love is like the first
hacked.
Series is where they have their vision is a camera, it's being recorded and it's all about
that was done
it starts sure. really nicely in terms of he's been to an interview and he's watching his footage back to see how he did. So he's gauging his opinion
very
by looking at their expressions. And then it goes into like the infidelity of his wife and then seeing that. And it's like, fuck, that's probably the most brutal way you could probably find out about that kind of thing when you visually see it through someone else's eyes. And you can just press a button and send your entire stream of visual throughout the day.
Imagine sending that to your mum.
And then just being like, fuck, Jesus
Christ.
That's
way worse than a text. Shit.
What were you searching on Reddit? No, I wasn't searching. It was. I scrolled down.
Why is your whole body shaking in rhythm?
Jesus Christ! It was trot. He kept selecting these things.
That's
honestly.
Interesting though. Like, Yeah.
Would you want to be able to record everything you visually saw?
A lot of the time I'm like, I wish I could record what I'm seeing right now.
Yeah, isn't that the issue they had? Look at that again. That would be great.
That's literally the issue they had with Google Glass. Everywhere in California started like coffee shops saying, no Google Glass here, you can't have that shit here. You would have like this kind of disconnect between, you know, these people who obviously like want to keep their privacy, but also it is a cool thing because you could film amazing events without, you know, I guess in this situation it stores as much as you want because it's fucking, you know, a concept.
Do you reckon if it gets to the point where, you know, it's very non-intrusive, like having a Google Glass or whatever, so it's like a contact lens or whatever, or even better, it's just not better, but just part of your eye, that your sense of presence is challenged. For example, if you know I'll that you can it watch it later, do you have to really be in the moment?
Yeah, but that is a question on now, isn't it? Because people who film fucking fireworks displays,
you're looking at the fucking,
but you're filming it through your shitty camera from a distance.
Do you think that will go to the extreme? Zoom?
And are you going to watch it later? Are you really going to watch it later? Fucking fireworks display, like
you can't get but if it's your eyes
or a concert as well, equivalent a concert. Unless you're filming yourself and your friends like having a good time at a concert, why are you filming the stage?
Yeah, that's true.
But imagine if you had the technology. If we have the technology of literally capturing your senses and everything as they are.
Yeah.
Exactly, and you could look around, kind of like a VR experience. Of the moment you've just recorded, that's completely different, right? That's not slimming the experience.
Like you say, the opportunity to experience it another time.
Yeah.
Which, would be completely new to humans.
But,
really.
How would you edit that time? How do you edit, like, that kind of, like...
You don't really.
Because, obviously, you're like, oh, cool, can I have a highlights reel of this, please? Fucking hell, that's 24 hours worth of footage right here.
But then you're thinking in terms
take me
of
to 5 p.m. and 8 p.m.
Yeah.
The following happens between 5 p.m. and 8 p.m.
That's exactly what would happen. Yeah. It was like the moments I looked at that person or that part of that person. Yeah. Give me all of those, please.
And then you've just got chunks of... Well, that's the thing. And that was the thing in this episode as well. Like, kind of like the sexuality of it. Like, you know, because
voyeurism.
I'm guessing an ideal situation would be if you had that technology, you could then create a device that would then shut that technology off in certain environments. Like, for example, going to the cinema. Yeah. Like,
it's unable to record.
It's then like it's cutting like off, like they have in hospitals where they cut off radio signal for phones.
No, Ross, it's more like areas. Tesco trolleys. You know, when you try and take a trolley past the point,
park and
the magnet
the wheels stop.
I just want the fucking trolley.
Please, I just need to take this for reasons.
Smith needs to wheel me away from Asda.
I need to drop
in this trolley
nearby river. I need to just ditch it somewhere, please. I want to be a vandal.
I'm a teenager. I'm reckless.
Let me, Tesco. God damn, I paid my pound.
I think the thing with the recording thing as well, that, like you're saying about the presence thing, like, I think first thing it would do, it would make people act much more precisely.
Yeah.
Because they know that, they don't want to waste time.
Always on cam, or do you think because it's so prevalent? Prevalent?
No, I mean of your own time.
You'd forget about it.
I mean of your own time. No, I think it would. Imagine, right, that you knew that you could experience things, right? You'd be out there collecting experiences so that you could create essentially a library of DVDs. And also age. As you get older, if you could experience what it was like to be, you know, fucking 18 again or whatever, that'd be just the best thing in the world,
right? So you need to watch... Sorry, there's another episode which is really interesting on it.
They explore
Episode 3,
of the current season?
Of the newest season, where they explore that exact mentality in kind of growing old, and then it's really good. And I actually do like Charlie Brooker's. I mean, sometimes he can be quite a dick in terms of if you watch any of his stuff, but this is really good and it's really interesting. And
you know, when you were saying about
interesting thought processes,
you were saying about Hat Films passively watching Rick and Morty and that sounds like the perfect Charles Fusion-y. If we watch Black Mirror and just did a commentary on the philosophies of it all.
Well, yeah, potentially.
That'd be interesting.
You could do.
Pause it a lot. Yeah. The thing.
We'd have to pause it a lot. Or discuss it afterwards, maybe.
Well, yeah, it's the type of thing where you would literally have to do like an afterthought because...
But then I guess that's what this is, right? I've just recently watched Black Mirror and then blah, blah, blah. We should all maybe give ourselves tasks.
Tasks. Go watch.
It's
homework.
It's like doing uni again.
Homework. Everyone. Sign up to Netflix, pay your money, and then go watch... the Rick and Morty thing I think should be good though. I mean, only because it's
funny
that we really enjoy as well, and I'm sure people. It's a shared experience thing. So if we, for example, filmed ourselves,
I think that'd be a Hat Films Extra thing, right?
Yeah, it would be Hat Films Extra. I don't think it'd be a main channel thing. Filmed ourselves, sat on a sofa. We'll watch the episode, laugh along with it, make joke. Well, you know, comment on it as we go. I don't know if we do a audio commentary, like, because what? I mean, we didn't make the fucking show, did we?
No.
So it wouldn't be just be like, at this stage, Justin said something hilarious at this point.
We'd have to do it.
It would just be us, our reactions at the time.
We'd have to do
would
it.
Would that be creepy or what? Like, would you think that'd be...
No, I think it would be like, at the start of the video, we'd be like, okay, here's a timer so that you can press play at the same time.
3, 2, 1, and let's watch a fucking thing together.
Yeah. 3, 2, 1, I get my dick out immediately.
Yeah. Instantly I do. Starts messing.
Every time I watch Rick and Morty... Just
his knob out for
it's a little
Morty.
Star pupil eyes. That's what gets me.
Yeah. Well, we could do that. Yeah. What if I could stream to you, Trot, my view at any point in time in the future?
So just interrupt.
Internet's got to a stage where you can stream directly from your brain, right?
Go on.
Through 8G, which is now available, and it streams at 5 teraflops a second. Which is fucking crazy. So that you know,
that's enough for the human field of view.
Huh? Do you think so? I think so.
I reckon that'd be.
I mean, a 1080 does about 1.5 teraflops. I think.
Motion sickness instantly worries me about that. You're looking around like instantaneous eye movement,
and you're sat there,
and I'm just sat there, just involuntarily looking,
strumming away,
and you're blinking,
strumming away, going, "God, yeah, you're having a great time here, Ross."
Yeah, I just wanted to share it with you, buddy.
I should really turn off that option that auto accepts calls as well.
Oh God, I'm with my mum, Ross. I can't see her anymore.
I'm about to dive with some sharks. Enjoy it with me, motherfucker. No, this is my worst nightmare. Why are you doing this? That'd be pretty fucking weird, wouldn't it?
Pretty weird, yeah.
But yeah, ultimately, you wouldn't be able to store all that shit. You wouldn't be able to store a constant stream in your head, and you wouldn't know what to do with it.
Oh God, that'd be horrible.
So you'd have to like...
Oh shit, you filled up my...
Yeah, you filled up my memory. My memory.
My actual memory with your memory.
And also, like, if you had an opportunity, so let's say you are really old and you're like, well, you know, I'm bored. And you decide that the technology's there. You decide that you want to live in a world of your memories. That was literally like you're walking around in a world of your actual memories. You can go anytime, anywhere in the world that you've experienced.
As long as you've been there, right?
That you've experienced, yeah. Do you think that would be much better? Do you think that would be better? Or would you rather just be like, well, let's just leave reality to reality and not do that?
Because if I couldn't tell, what's the difference? Really?
Well, that's the thing. Exactly, that's the thing. Because if you can't tell that it's not a real world, then what harm is it doing?
Reality.
But then is that the really ultimate kind of moral question?
Yeah, that's perception. That's the theories of perception.
Yeah, then ultimately you could then think about our own perception right now.
But then you realize you can't, like, I mean, if you're aware that you're in that world, you know that you can't grow, you can't change, you can't experience anything new.
I guess, yeah, the awareness.
So you're stuck with
the awareness
this.
Of the
but then
prior.
Ultimately, you know, what, 28 years worth of memories right now. You know, let's say you're 80 or something. That's 80 years worth of memories and places you've been. If you knew that from day one that you could collect all that stuff, and then when you're old and unable to actually go to these places or whatever, you could live in them.
Do you think
that would be a much nicer thing to do? Or would that be...
To a point, because...
Or would you just want to age gracefully and just go when you go?
I don't know, to be honest. I don't know what technology is going to be like, and whether it's going to be... Like, those memories, are they just going to be interactive... movies where I can't talk to
people. You'll be wandering around. You can talk to anyone that was there.
And they would interact back.
And you'll know, and effectively, if, I mean, this
I can
is
live
just,
in the
obviously
moment
it's a
forever.
Completely conceptual idea, but like, how cool would it be if, you know, they had all their memories from that point as well, and then, so they anything can, they tell you is everything they know.
Or it's a snapshot of
so
their
you've got
personality
a snapshot of,
at the time.
Yeah,
right?
Maybe, yeah.
So that whatever they've learned up to that point, I can talk to, interact with.
So if you never spoke to that person before, you're like, oh fuck, I've never actually spoken to them. You could learn something completely new there.
Actually, I never went up to them and tore their clothes off.
It'd be pretty crazy, wouldn't it?
I think I'd be a fucked up old man. That's what I'd be.
Yeah.
The ultimate voyeurism
really fucked up.
In my own brain.
Well, that's it. It's like that. Is that mentality of...
I want to go
up
to the
Eiffel
Tower.
You're invincible as well. You're invincible, effectively.
And jizz.
So you could just do anything
crazy
you like in
man.
Your reality and go back and change things to the way that you...
Doctor Strange is good, by the way.
Nice, thanks. Like and subscribe.
Ultimately, you know, yeah. thanks for watching, Charles. Reality's all in your head.
Yeah.
Dies in The Walking Dead.
Reality's all an illusion to you.
Jesus, really got there with that one.
Really can't, you can't put that in. That's an actual
just
spoiler.
Just beep out the name.